This is the SAP Developer News for February 22nd, 2024.
Hi everyone, and welcome to the SAP Developer News. The famous and very popular UI5 walkthrough for JavaScript has received a revamp and is now also available for TypeScript. The walkthrough is a great resource for beginners and also serves as great documentation for core features of UI5. The TypeScript version is now available on GitHub, including live previews of each step. Check it out and see you soon. Bye.
Did you know about Luigi? It is an enterprise-ready micro-frontend framework from SAP. Here you can see the micro-frontend framework in action. This Luigi app can host different frontend applications such as a React app, SAP UI5 app, SAP Fiori Elements application, an Angular app, all within a single Luigi application. All these different frontend applications can be developed, tested, deployed, and maintained independently by many distributed teams. The documentation is available on this GitHub page. And you could try this quick 5-minute tutorial on Introduction to Luigi.
Hello everybody! We developers are always curious to try our hands on new development tools. Recently, we have heard a lot about SAP Build and SAP Build Code solutions. Although these two solutions sound the same, let me tell you, there is a stark difference between their usages. What is SAP Build? SAP Build is a low-code solution that helps us accelerate application development, process automation, and design business websites with drag-and-drop simplicity. These tools are designed keeping business experts in focus irrespective of their coding skills. Then, what is SAP Build Code? A generative AI-based code development environment with a tool Copilot optimized for Java and JavaScript application development for seamless end-to-end coding, testing, integration, and application lifecycle management. This tool is to be used by professional software developers. Would you like to know more differences, use case scenarios, fusion development concept using these two solutions? Then kindly refer to the blog post by our product expert, Francesca Mikli. We are not done yet. I have one more fascinating news. SAP is offering SAP Build Hackathon in the month of April. It's a 3-day virtual event from 16th to 18th April. Now it's your chance to try out SAP Build solutions and get your hands dirty by creating business applications or automating mundane tasks that occur on your day-to-day business. Here you get to join our SAP Build experts, peers, to learn about their no-code journeys, share ideas and experiences. Sounds great, right? For more details, check the blog post by product expert Manuel Nomeslo. Links for the blogs and hackathon registration is provided in the description box below. Until next time, keep building. Thank you.
Last weekend, the new 2024 QRC1 version of SAP Analytics Cloud was released, and with that, the initial release of Just Ask. Just Ask is the new natural language query feature powered by AI. With Just Ask, any user can query SAC data models by asking questions in everyday English. It supports acquired data models in SAP Analytics Cloud and SAP DataSphere models. For all details about Just Ask and its configuration steps, please check the blog post by Francois Imberton. But don't forget to explore all Q1 release features with our experts demoing them. Links are in the description. SAP DataSphere product management prepared a What's New post for you as well. There were some interesting new features released last month, like SQL script in transformation flows, or the repository folders to organize the objects in your spaces. While we are discussing topics related to SAP Analytics Cloud and SAP DataSphere, I would like to draw your attention to the brand new learnings available to help guide you through some key connectivity topics between both. This learning is brought to you by the SAP Enterprise Support Value Maps organization. A one-time registration in SAP Learning Hub edition for SAP Enterprise Support using a valid S user might be required